gentiment d'accueillir Madame Corey Ray et Monsieur Dan Cadden. Both films, and they were both the first film of their directors. Did you notice other points in common? How did they work with the one and the other? How was the process different if it was on both films?
That's a great question. I think you know, the interesting thing is there are a lot of similarities between Pete.
We're both 9 feet tall.
But I think the job of the producer when you have a new director is to make sure that you're surrounding them with a really great leadership team, very experienced people in lead positions who can help you know, teach them about the process, because most directors come with one specialty. For Pete, he was an animator. He spent a little time in story, but he was mostly an animator. Dan comes from story. And so they know those areas very, very well. And the job, my job, is to make sure that I surround them with the right people in all of the other areas. But they're both incredibly brilliant filmmakers and very generous with their teams. So they are quite a lock and great sense of humor.
C'est une très bonne question parce qu'ils ont en fait beaucoup de points communs. Il me se dit qu'ils font tous les deux 1m90. Le boulot d'une productrice sur un film qui est réalisé par un débutant, c'est d'organiser autour de lui une équipe de qualité, une grande équipe avec quelqu'un d'intéressant à chaque poste. Parce qu'il faut qu'à chaque poste, le directeur de poste puisse bien renseigner le réalisateur qui lui est un débutant. Les deux réalisateurs sont très compétents dans leur propre domaine. Pete venait plutôt de l'animation et Dan du scénario. Et ils connaissent très bien ce domaine de départ. Et moi, mon travail, c'est de les entourer de collaborateurs qui puissent les renseigner sur les autres aspects, ceux qu'ils connaissent peut-être moins. Mais ils sont tous les deux des personnes très généreuses avec leur équipe et tous les deux deux personnes avec un grand sens de l'humour. Possibilities, or the avenues, or the possibilities. And when did you both came into the project, at what stage?
I think early on we got together with Pete Docter, the original director, and John Lasseter, and talked about, just tried to discover if there was a story here that we wanted to tell. In doing that, we decided that we wanted to tell a story that dove into the relationship of Mike and Sully a little more, and that's where the idea of doing a prequel, going back in time and seeing the moment where they actually met, occurred. In that meeting, I don't think there were too many other ideas. There might have been one or two thrown around, but nothing that interests us quite as much as the prequel did. And as far as our joining the project...
Yeah, it was during that time. We were both on probably about 5 years ago at the beginning.
Yeah.
Alors au début, on s'est réunis, il y avait Pete Docter, il y avait John Lasseter, et on s'est demandé tous quelle histoire on avait envie de raconter avec ces personnages. Et assez vite, on est tombé d'accord sur l'idée qu'on voulait parler de la relation amicale et de la construction de l'amitié entre Bob et Sully. Et on voulait ensuite assez rapidement parler de leur rencontre, c'était finalement le meilleur moyen. Et on n'a pas eu, je pense, pendant cette première réunion, beaucoup d'autres idées. Donc l'idée d'un prequel est venue assez rapidement. Et c'était à peu près il y a 5 ans.
I have to imagine that the prequel is slightly more difficult just because you are trying to, you have to tell a story that is unpredictable even though the audience knows the ending. So I think it's very challenging, and it was on this film for sure.
Je n'ai moi-même jamais travaillé sur une suite, mais j'imagine que le prequel c'est plus compliqué parce que quelle que soit l'histoire que l'on raconte, il n'y a rien à faire. Le public sait où ça va aller, sait que ça va finir, comment ça va finir.
To me as well. I think that a prequel is a lot more difficult for the reasons Corey mentioned. But as a result, we came up with a story where knowing the ending was a good thing up front, where we wanted to we wanted you to know that things weren't going to work out for Mike as you're learning how much it means to him. We felt that that's where the tension came from, and that was a big part of our story, was heading toward an ending that you almost didn't want to see happen. And then the question becomes, well, when this happens, how is it going to be okay? How is it going to feel for Mike?
Right.
So I don't think just any story lends itself to being a prequel, but I think that this one did.
Oui, j'ai aussi l'impression qu'un prequel, c'est quelque chose de plus difficile, c'est plus difficile à concevoir et à mettre en place. Mais nous, on a essayé dans ce film d'utiliser le fait que le public sait comment ça va finir et qu'ils vont finalement avoir une carrière en tant que monstre. La question, on sait donc que Bob va s'en sortir et va y arriver. Mais la question, c'est comment va-t-il y arriver? Quel est le processus? Comment ça se passe?